Horus is a wearable device for blind and vision impaired people. It's basically a headset with cameras and a powerful pocket computer that stays in the pocket and processes all the images in real time.
One day, we were in Genoa, just in front of the train station there, we met a blind person.
And he begged for help to reach the bus stop. And that event made us wonder all the difficulties that the people who have lost sight or are losing it have to face every day. And we discovered that we could move our focus, not from computer vision to another topic, but bringing vision from robotics to people who need it, not robots.
We have a bone conduction headset plus a stereo vision system and a processing unit which is powered by NVIDIA Jetson platform. The headset basically acquires images and streams them to the processor where the deep learning and computer vision algorithms run. The current status of our project is of advanced prototype. We've made several iterations and we now have a custom board with a Tegra processor and our own software comprising several functionalities.
And the way it's being used today is we have a pool of testers and organizations that are helping us testing the device, the packaging and everything. We also have one blind employee who is testing it every day.
We're working on face recognition. And there we are working both on face detection and also online learning, so to allow the blind person to learn the faces of new people on the go while he's using the device. Then we have object recognition, which basically works in a very similar way, but the underlying algorithms are a little bit different. Then we have text reading.
I cannot fully express my gratitude to the exceptional team at Doubleday.
And by text reading, I mean that the device can recognize printed text, for example, on books.
Thank you especially to Bill Thomas.
And the device can also help the blind person in moving around the city or also indoor spaces. And in order to do that, we're leveraging the power of stereo vision. We're trying to understand what's in front of the person, like obstacles, signs, and then creating some sort of audible map of the environment for the blind person, so that when he moves around, he can understand what's in front of him and then avoid any obstacles that he might find on the way. Then we have scene captioning. The person queries the device through like the press of a button for a description of what the cameras are seeing, and then to generate a complete sentence that tries to describe what's in front of the blind person. All of it is obtained through deep learning.
A group of people sitting around the table with laptops.
We make extensive use of deep learning and computer vision in our product because if you want to be useful, you need to gather all the possible information from the surrounding environment. And using only classical computer vision approaches, that's not possible.
Our work is also to bring the same algorithms and make them run on our mobile platform. And this is made possible by NVIDIA's Jetson platform, because it allows for high performance and also power efficient computing in a small form factor. When we release our product, our goal is to basically radically change their lives because we want to make the world more accessible to them.
We cannot change the accessibility of every city, in every country, in every nation, but we can create something that can bridge a gap, can make what's not accessible, accessible to everybody.